I first became seriously interested in meditation when I went along to an evening class given by John Crook, who was a psychology lecturer at Bristol University. And these were evening classes in Zen Buddhism. And we had to sit there and meditate, and it was so difficult. He said, sit there and let the thoughts go. Anything that comes along, he said, let it come, let it be, let it go. Oh, it's so difficult. These terrible thoughts, as soon as you let one go, poor, there's another one. And he said, then I always remembered from the first class I ever went to, he said, when you've practiced this a lot, the mind becomes still. It becomes so still that you could hear a woodlouse crawling across the floor on the other side of the room. And I realised how far my mind was from that kind of stillness. There's no way I could hear a woodlouse at the 10 feet. And I became enthusiastic about practising meditation. Now, it's very easy to say, oh, I'm going to meditate every day, and then, you know, you don't, and you get disheartened, and you try it, and so on, and so on. But eventually, I went on a retreat run by John. He owns a hill farm in Wales, remote place. It has no gas, no electricity, no telephone, really no contact with the outside world. It's a couple of miles from the nearest road. And the first time I ever went there was the depth of winter, that terrible winter of 1982 when the snow was 15 foot deep and the temperature was minus 20, and it was a terrible winter. And I arrived there in the night, in the dark, and I was 8 months pregnant. And they came down to meet me with a walking stick and a torch, and I struggled up, you know, up to this house. And spent 5 days there with a small group of people with very strict rules. You don't speak, no making eye contact with other people, everything done in silence. Meditate half an hour, walk around for 5 minutes, meditate half an hour. And that was a fantastic experience. I learned so much. I enjoyed not having to speak, not having to be somebody to somebody else, and simply to concentrate on let it go, let it be, let the thoughts go, still the mind, and actually look into what it means to be aware. Look at self. Look at it. How is it? That takes a still mind, and well, I've been practicing that for 20 years.